welcome on our next speaker, who is Mr. Kishore Narne, who is the Associate Director of Motilal Oswal Group. Kishore is going to be talking about the Indian currency market. Kishore is the Associate Director of Motilal Oswal Group, and he currently leads the commodity and currency business for the group. Okay? He has been the winner of India's Best Market Analyst Commodities and Zee Business for 2011. And Motilal Oswal, under his leadership, has been awarded India's Best Market Analyst Forex from Zee Business in 2014 and Market Excellent Award Bullion.
Thank you very much. Good morning, all. Myself is Kishore. I come from India. We are one of the largest broking houses in Indian equities as well as commodities and currency markets. Currency markets in India have been a very recent phenomenon. It's been just a decade now, 11 to 12 years old, predominantly dominated by banks and corporates, of course. And the retail forex market or retail speculative forex market is a very small market as far as organized sector is concerned in India. About our group, we are a little over 30 years old into the markets. We have a little over a million customers in India, and we manage around 600 billion rupees of assets in India. That's our group, and we are present in nearly over around 500 cities in India. That's a large retail footprint which we have. Coming to the markets, actually, so in India, currency markets are predominantly, again, what you call, they're listed on equity bourses, equity exchanges. And we have four domestic pairs. Of course, the dollar rupee, that's the major pair. So 80-85% of the volumes come from dollar rupee pair, and rest of all the pound rupee as well as the euro rupee and JPY, the Japanese yen rupee, are the three other pairs. We do also have the international crosses, the euro dollar and GBP euro, euro dollar, pound dollar, all the four of the international crosses, but they're traded in a very, what you call, a very small, tiny, negligent portion of that. Again, see, online trading is a phenomena recently been developed in India, and most of the brokers following the global models have been now turning into online models. The brokerage race is on to go to the zero, like how the global markets are evolving. Everyone is chasing the zero brokerage kind of thing. So that's how the markets are evolving. There also, it's predominantly software-based online trading companies which are chasing the markets now. When I compare domestic markets, so right now, the National Stock Exchange and Bombay Stock Exchange, they are the two large stock exchanges we have, and both of them have very neck-to-neck competition as well as the market share of forex trading is concerned. So roughly around 49-51%, so typical like the Pepsi and Coke of the world, like they're neck-to-neck on the volumes front. But when I consider the participants on the open interest level, the participants, if I see 50-55% of the participants will be proprietary traders, the members trading for themselves. But if I consider on the volume front, roughly around 30-35% of volume comes from algos, 20-25% comes from retail, and rest comes from corporates, and the foreign institutional investors, the FIs or FPIs, constitute around 10% of the volumes on the exchange. So that's the volume portion. But what makes Indian markets interesting is, of course, the time zone which we fall into. Again, most of the market, about the rupee dollar, even today, it's onshore is now picking up, the onshore and offshore, but Singapore is a major offshore market for dollar rupee, and second by Dubai, where DGCX, of course, is a market for dollar rupee. London is evolving as one of the market for dollar rupee. Even CME has a pair So, but considering all these things, but still, the dollar rupee pair trading 83% of total volume on a daily basis is still a onshore market. That's the Indian domestic market. So, I think that's where the domestic markets become a bit important. On the volume front, about roughly around $8 billion worth of trade happens every day on the exchanges. That's on the derivatives front. The OTC market size of dollar rupee is roughly around $30-35 billion a day. So still, the exchange traded derivative markets are slightly, let's say 15% of the total volumes, but the OTC still dominates the market. And OTC, of course, is dominated by the banks as well as the financial institutions. So retail doesn't go into OTC markets, of course, and they're not been allowed as per the regulatory setup in India. So retail comes into the exchanges. It's a very small, tiny lot of $1,000, dollar rupee. And so it makes an extremely small lot to trade. So a huge amount of retail participation comes there onto the exchange platform. On the OTC itself, roughly around 49-50% is swaps, around 48-50% is forwards. So again, that market is also divided equally into forwards and swaps. So the spot market. So that's again a concern where majority of the volumes comes from swaps. On the timing front, the market opens at around 9 a.m. in India. Indian time and shuts down at around 5 p.m. India time. But most of the volumes happens post European opening. So let's say in the second half of the day. So once the Europe market opens, probably around 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock India time. That's where the large amount of volumes happen. And what makes it exciting for you guys is that. There's a huge amount of arbitrage opportunities which perk up time to time. So you have Singapore offshore market as well as DGCX offshore market. So at times we get 10 to 15 paisa, 10 to 15 paisa arbitrage difference in that. So in that setup, people can just buy Dubai pair and sell India, or buy India and sell Dubai. So there's a lot of opportunities between India and Singapore, between Dubai and India. So there's a significant spread difference between the offshore market and onshore market. On an average, the spread is around 8 paisa, which goes up to around 13 paisa, which makes a significant returns on the arbitrage itself. Dubai plays a key role here. Of course, we have being a DGCX, being a late night market, and post Indian close, most of our Indian domestic players also look forward for Indian Dubai markets. So we have a significant participation in Dubai from India, and the difference between, despite all these things, the DGCX volumes comes close to around 20% of the domestic volumes. So India still is a large market, and what we are doing right now is that to give this access to retail customers, a lot of retail customers, what we're trying to do is we're trying to incorporate our trading platform into MetaTrader 5. So MetaTrader 5, as you all know, that it's one of the beautiful softwares which we have to trade currencies. So we're trying to integrate that with that. So to a large segment of clients, it would be available through MetaTrader 5, so you can associate with Motilal Oswal and trade in domestic Indian futures markets on the exchanges, and through your own softwares and your own algorithms, your own logic, whatever you built into the MetaTrader 5, and get your confirmation instantly. So that's it from my side, and any questions, I'll be anyway available here, so I'll be open to taking that. Thank you very much.